Get ready to match the stars from out of this world. Joe Alaskey. From Mr. Belvedere, Eileen Pratt. Match game zone, Charles Nelson Reilly. Television favorite, Sally Struthers. From Knot's Landing, Chris Lemmon. And from Snoop, Daphne Maxwell Reid. As we play the all-new star-studded Match Game. And here's the star of Match Game, Ross Shafer.
Welcome to Match Game, everybody. Thank you for joining us. Now, I need you to say hello to our stars for being here.
Oh, yes. Hello, stars.
Thank you. This is something that came up. One of the audience members came up to me and asked me, does Chris do an impression of his father, Jack?
No, I'm much too tall to do my father.
You're much too tall.
Yes. No, Joe does a great impression of my father. I do a great impression of Walter Matthau.
That's how much you know. That's not cornflakes. That's linguine.
Wait a minute. What is that? The case of the cat people?
Oh, well, they checked out. Oh, never mind.
And who are you, anyway?
There's a little bit of Alan Alda, I think, in there, too, wasn't there?
Yeah, well, I don't know.
Oh, we don't know. Let's say hi to our contestants here. Hi, Jeff. You've done a fine job here.
Oh,
you've done
you.
Very well. $12,500 so far.
You bet.
Returning champion, Jeff. And this is our new challenger. Hi, Patty.
Hi.
Now, Patty, would you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yes, my name is Patty Healy. I live here in Los Angeles, where I work as a bartender.
All right. You know how we play Match Game.
Hi.
It's easy. The goal is to match as many of our celebrities as you can. Every correct match is worth $50. And the one who scores the most at the end of the game is the winner, gets to keep the money and play Super Match, which is a shot at $10,000. All right, Jeff, big guy, you get to make your selection first. Do you want question A or question B?
Let's go with A.
You're going to go with A. Okay, stars.
Okay.
And this one is about Dumb Donald.
Oh, boy.
Dumb Donald is really dumb.
How dumb is he?
Well, he is so dumb that he thinks the TV show Twin Peaks is about blank. Can't you, Chris? All right, Jeffrey. Dumb Donald is really dumb. He thinks the TV show Twin Peaks is about blank.
Dolly Parton.
Dolly Parton. See, the audience happens to agree with you. The audience likes that. Yeah, Chris.
I said that Twin Peaks was about a Playboy bunny.
A Playboy bunny?
Oh, that's a
good one.
Show here.
Sally, Twin Peaks. Imagine yourself being dumb. What would you think Twin Peaks would be?
Stumble out of bed and stumble to the kitchen, pour myself a glass.
Okay.
Oh, what a surprise.
What a surprise. Ilene, he thinks the TV show Twin Peaks is about
a lady who graced this stage not too very long ago.
Dolly Parton. Okay, Joe, can you match Dolly Parton?
You know, Jack Lemmon's not the only Jack I do. I think even Nicholson would say Dolly Parton.
Dolly Parton. Very, very well. Now, Daphne, is that what you thought? Did you think that Dumb Donald thought Twin Peaks was Dolly Parton?
Well, I'm usually pretty dumb, too, but if it was 10 years ago, I thought it was me, but it's Dolly Parton.
It's Dolly Parton. Five matches. Okay, Patty, we're going to see how well you do with this one. Yeah. All right, you all know that Ted Turner is trying to colorize all those black and white movies. Well, he's also a rich man. He just bought the L.A. Zoo, and now he's going to colorize the blanks. Sally, what are you doing up there?
I'm doing artwork that you're going to love later.
We better.
Okay.
It better be a suitable for the Smithsonian. Okay, Patty. You know that Ted Turner's trying to colorize all those black and white movies? He just bought the L.A. Zoo, and now he's trying to colorize the blanks.
The zebras.
The zebras. He's got that dumb Chris look on his face.
It just, I went for a kind of a poetry kind of thing here. He's trying to colorize the critters.
He was just trying to be vague enough to cover enough of the animals. And he, Sally?
I may be slow, but I'm correct.
Only the white. See, black and white movies is misleading. Only the white is colored. So I said polar bear. I'm sorry.
Polar bear.
Him.
All right, at the zoo, he wants to colorize the blanks, Ilene.
The appropriate answer is zebra.
Zebra, oh, sure.
Actually, you can just call me Woody. And I would just like to say this about colorization. I don't think that he should go to the zoo and colorize the pandas or the zebras.
Or the zebras. Matches here, Daphne.
There's also penguins, but I didn't write that.
You wrote zebras. You wrote zebras. Four matches. You have 200. Jeff, you have $250. We're going to be back with matchup where you can build up your score by playing against the clock right after these words. Jeff has 250, and Patty, you have 200. It's time for matchup now. And this is where you can build up your score by playing against the clock. Patty, you're behind right now, so we'll start with you. You can play with any one of our stars. Who would you like to play with?
I'd like to play with Ilene, please.
All right, Patty, look, we're going to show you a series of possible matchups. Use the buttons there on your secret screen, and you select the answer you think is best. Every time Ilene agrees with you, you get $50. You have 30 seconds to get as many as you can. Ready? Go. Fly bank. Fly ball, fly me.
Fly ball.
Right. Stick blank. Stick shift, stick in the mud.
Stick shift.
Match. Beaver blank. Beaver dam, beaver cleaver.
Beaver cleaver.
Match. Bo blank. Bo peep, Bo Derek.
Bo Derek.
Match. Party blank. Party animal, party pooper.
Party pooper.
No match. Flip blank. Flip Wilson, flip flop.
Flip Wilson.
Match. Jump blank. We got some matches. We got some matches there. Five matches. Your turn to play a matchup. Who would you like to play with, Jeff?
Let's try Joe again.
I'm ready.
Joe Williams, ready. Remember now, you get $50 per match. Get as many as you can in 30 seconds. Both ready?
Yes.
Go. Milton blank. Milton Bradley, Milton Berle.
Milton Berle.
No match.
Too bad.
Head blank. Head start, head and shoulders.
Head to start.
Match. Lemon blank. Lemon pledge, lemon meringue.
Lemon meringue.
Match. Tooth blank. Tooth decay, tooth fairy.
Tooth fairy.
Match. White blank. White night, white Christmas.
White night.
Match. Detroit blank. Detroit Lions, Detroit Tigers.
Detroit Tigers.
No match. Blank, meat blank. Meat ball, meat market. You're in the champion seat, so you'll get to make a selection. Question A or B?
Let's try B this time.
All right. A shot here. Okay, stars. Wild Wilma is really uninhibited.
Oh, hello, uninhibited. Is she, Ross?
She even posed nude for her blank photo. Wild Wilma is really uninhibited. She even posed nude for her blank. Okay, everybody, Joe, have you got yours ready?
No.
No?
No, I do.
Now you do. Now let's play. Jeff, Wild Wilma is really uninhibited. She even posed nude for her blank photo.
Her wedding photo.
I didn't think of it. The wedding photo.
That's
Chris. She posed nude for her blank photo.
It's going to be one of those 3 out of 3 days. I'm batting 1,000 today. I just want you to know. I feel real good about this
wedding
show.
Wedding photo.
No, I didn't say wedding photo. I said something that I thought was much funnier, but it's not. Driver's license.
Driver's license. Yeah. I think like that one too, Sally. We're looking for a wedding photo.
I know, but I didn't think anybody would marry Wild Wilma, being the wild woman that she was. So I saw her down at the DMV and
in her driver's license.
Just to keep the show varied, I spelt it wrong.
Right. Ilene, she was wild. She posed nude for her blank photo.
Yeah, her driver's license.
I know, that's what I thought. Joe?
Yeah, well, I've been a bus driver for a long time.
Look at this. Look at this. 5 for 5. Yeah. All right, Daphne.
It's a clean sweep.
Another driver's license photo. Score is still tied, 450 to 450. Patty, we'll see how you do with this one. Okay. Magician David Copperfield said, President Bush asked me to create a new illusion. He wants me to make blank disappear. Magician David Copperfield said, President Bush asked me to create a new illusion. He wants me to make blank disappear. Charles?
No, I can't wait.
He's gonna change. Charles, do you want to be mean?
Yeah, no.
I'm changing.
You're changing yours too?
That's out of here.
Oh my.
Well, now wait a minute.
We've had a fit of conscience here at the match game.
Well, how silly.
You gotta go with the answer. She's gonna.
All right, everybody's in now. Okay.
We haven't had this much trouble since the Roseanne Barr question.
All right, the conscience hit them. So, Patty, listen to this. Magician David Copperfield said, President Bush asked me to create a new illusion. He wants me to make blank disappear.
Barbara.
Barbara.
Talk about me.
We're talking
to me. And you were worried? You know something about the marriage we don't know? All right, let's see.
You know, gosh, Ross, suddenly I sort of feel like an archangel here.
President Bush wants to make blank disappear, Chris.
Well, you know, I thought I was mean and nasty, but Syria doesn't even hold a straw to that.
Syria.
Very serious.
Very serious. Syria. Sally.
Well, I didn't want to name a particular country because then I thought I'd get letters from everyone that lived in that country.
Sure.
So I named an entire region. The Middle East.
Well, you didn't name Barbara.
Well, I didn't want to, you know, list a special country because I got sort of get letters from a lot of special countries. So I listed as a specific country, so I said the Middle East.
You said the Middle East. Ilene, you had your answer almost immediately.
Oh, I know.
Yes, President Bush wants to make blank disappear. What was the blank?
Oh, gee. I don't even know whether I should say what I'm going to not say now. Maybe President, never mind. Dan Quayle.
Dan Quayle. Yeah. Whatever would make you pick Dan Quayle. Joe.
Well, as a political analyst,
yes.
Let me just say that the correct answer is Congress, but the funny answer is Dan Quayle.
Dan Quayle. Daphne, look at this. We haven't had a match in two questions so far. Help us out. We're looking for Barbara.
I matched Ilene.
You got Quayle, too. We have no matches.
0 for 0.
All right, we couldn't get a match. On our questions, and it's time now for final matchup. Whoever wins this round wins the game and a chance to play for a possible $10,000.
Oh,
you're in the champion's chair here, Jeff, so you'll get to go first. Who do you want to play for?
Sally.
Okay,
all right,
Jeff.
Sally. Now, this time, every matchup will be worth $100. We're going to give you 45 seconds this time to get as many as you can. Go as far as you can. You both have $450. You ready?
Ready.
You ready, Sal?
Oh, yes, Ross.
Okay. Go! Blank herring. Red herring, pickled herring.
Red herring.
Match. Blank code. Morse code, zip code.
Morse code.
No match. Blank tube. Inner tube, boob tube.
Inner tube.
Match. Blank bride. Blushing bride, princess bride.
Blushing bride.
No match. Blank hanger. Cliffhanger, clothes hanger.
Cliffhanger.
Match. Blank bowl. Rose bowl, Super Bowl.
Super Bowl.
Match. Blank rehearsal. Dress rehearsal, wedding rehearsal.
Dress rehearsal.
Match. Blank hall. Annie Hall, Arsenio Hall.
Arsenio Hall.
Match. Blank sister. Sob sister. Twisted sister.
Twisted sister.
Match. Blank temple. Mormon temple.
All right.
Oh, what a good time. Score is 11:50 with Jeff. Patty, you have 4:50. This is your chance now to go for the win. Who do you want to play with?
I'd like to play with Charles, please.
Okay, dear. Charles.
Good luck, sweetheart.
All right. All right, remember, you have 450. He has 1150. You have to beat 1150 to win. All right, let's have 45 seconds on the clock. Ready? Go. Blank Robinson. Jackie Robinson, Mrs. Robinson.
Mrs. Robinson.
No match. Blank attack. Sneak attack. Big Mac attack.
Sneak attack.
No match. Blank toy. Boy toy. Tinker toy.
Tinker toy.
No match. Blank shock. Sticker shock. Future shock.
Future shock.
Match. Blank Marx. Karl Marx. Harpo Marx.
Harpo Marx.
No match. Blank women. Designing women. Little women.
Designing women.
Match. Blank Simpson. Bart Simpson, O.J. Simpson.
O.J. Simpson.
Match. Blank gown. Evening gown, cap and gown.
Evening gown.
Match. Blank Eden. Barbara Eden, east of Eden.
Barbara Eden.
Match. Blank Barry.
Oh. Oh. Out of time. You're the winner.
Jeff knows all about this part of the show. This is the Big Money Super Match where you can win over $10,000. You ready?
Okay.
Okay, recently we polled a studio audience and got their best response to this. Happy blank. Happy blank. Now, if you can guess the most popular answer, you get $500. Second most popular answer, $250. The third best answer, $100. Now, to help you, you can enlist the aid of three of our celebrities. Which three would you like to help you?
Joe? I'll go with the easy one. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Who else? Charles?
Happy days!
Happy days. All right. Daphne. And Daphne.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays. All right, happy holidays. Happy days. Happy birthday. You can use one of those or one of your own.
I think the old standard. Happy birthday.
Yeah. Well, this is a happy birthday. All right. Let's take a look. What was the $100 answer? Happy face.
What?
Nobody had that one, did we? No. The $250 answer was? Happy days.
Yo!
See, this is the one you want. The $500 answer, the one we're looking for, is happy birthday. Yeah! All right, you've won $500. That means you'll be playing for at least 10 times that, or $5,000 by matching one of our celebrities head to head. You can double that amount if you get a lucky spin on the star wheel. So why don't we get it in here and see how he does? Take a step up there, if you will, Jeff.
Can I just check the time quickly?
Can you check the time? Certainly. Okay. All right, now spin the pointer. Whichever star it lands on, Jeff will be your partner in the head to head. If it lands on a dot, that's double the money, or $10,000. Jeff, give us one of those big hearty spins you have.
Okay, come on, double. Come on, double.
Your partner, you're going to be playing for $10,000. To win the money, you must match Joe head-to-head. Remember, this time we have to have an exact match.
Good luck.
Please turn and face me if you can, and no help from the audience. We really don't need any distractions on this. Joe, please write down your answer to this. Blank rabbit. Blank rabbit. All right, Joe looks like he has his. Jeff, what's your answer for blank rabbit?
This one's tough, but I'm going to go with Roger Rabbit.
Yeah! All right, for $10,000, Joe, can you match Roger Rabbit?
Well, you know, there are a lot of rabbits in the business, Doc. Like Roger Rabbit. Yeah!
$650. You're going to come back tomorrow.
No problem.
All right, folks. We're going to go. We'll see you next time on Match Game.
Departing contestants will receive Relaxo.
Television production.